Now that many researchers have started truly using single-cell RNA-seq methods, the samples are getting more numerous and the datasets are getting larger. Early this year, it became possible to integrate multiple single-cell RNA-seq samples in Chipster. Now the larger datasets are requiring lots of memory and computing time in the integration step. We thus added two new options. Firstly, instead of using the default canonical correlation analysis, or CCA, in the anchor identification step, it is now also possible to choose to use the reciprocal PCA approach. The R-PCA option is faster and more conservative. Now, when to use this new option then? R-PCA is a good option when there are a lot of cells in one dataset that have no matching type in the other. When the datasets originate from the same platform, for example, from multiple lanes of 10x genomic device. And when there are a large number of datasets or cells to integrate. CCA, then again, is to be used when cell types are well conserved, but there are great differences in gene expression across different samples. So, for example, when experimental conditions introduce very strong expression shifts, or when combining datasets across modalities and species. Like said, the R-PCA makes the analysis faster and is thus often a good option for larger datasets. However, it also requires a fair amount of memory to integrate several samples, as each of them are compared to each other. For example, if there are 10 samples in the session, this means 45 comparisons are made altogether. Even the large computing nodes used by our Chipster server may run out of memory if the samples are very large. If the memory runs out, the tool will fail, and you can see it in the log. This tool was successful, and you can see the end of file tag here. Should it fail, due to the memory running out, the output would be cut, kind of mid-sentence. And if you check the memory usage here, you would see that the used memory would be closer to the limit. One possible solution to this would then be to choose to use just one or few of the samples as references for the integration. Now, if you have 10 samples and use only one of them as the reference, only 9 comparisons are performed instead of 45, decreasing the time and memory needed drastically. SURAP developers mention that they have nonetheless observed strikingly similar results with this method. Naturally, this might not be the case if the samples are very different from each other, or if the reference is not representing the data well. In the SURAP vignette, they choose to use 2 samples, one male and one female, as references to better represent the full dataset. In Chipster, choosing the references is done with this parameter here. If it is left as it is, full comparison between all the samples is performed. To choose samples as references, you simply type the sample names here, separated with comma. Please be very careful with the names, they are case sensitive. You can check the names of the samples, for example, from the parameter used in the setup tool.